This is the plaintiff, Scott Thibodeau. He says he met the defendant at work, brought him a sandwich at McDonald's, and then he let him move into his place so they could share the rent. Everything was fine. Until the defendant got back together with his ex, he stopped paying rent and then just moved out. He still owes him $2,087.40 for back rent and utilities. And he's suing the freeloader for just that today. This is the defendant, Christopher Mead. He says he doesn't know what the plaintiff's beef is because he paid all his rent and utilities while he was living there. That's right. He can't understand why he's being sued today because he doesn't owe this plaintiff any money. And he looks forward to presenting his defense in court today. He's accused of letting a buddy down.
All parties, please raise your right hand.
Welcome back to the People's Court. Next case in the docket, these litigants met at McDonald's. They moved in together. The plaintiff says the defendant bailed because he wanted to get back with his ex. But the defendant says he's all paid up. It's the case of you don't deserve a break today.
Thank you. Mr. Thibodeau, you are suing your former roommate for $2,087.40 that you say he owes you for bailing. Tell me what the arrangement was. You two met how? You worked at the same place?
Yes, we got hired on the same day, and I met him in before we had our orientation.
Okay, and you became friends?
Yes.
All right, tell me about that.
He's just a real friendly guy. We had a couple days of orientation, so I had to get a breakfast sandwich one day, so I bought him one and said, here, I got an extra sandwich for you, and we became friends after
and
that.
And the next thing that happens, we move in together. All right.
Yeah.
Proving once again that a sausage egg McMuffin is a secret to life. All right, so you end up deciding to move in together because why?
Well, what happened was he was going to possibly get kicked out of his house. He was worried that he was going to have nowhere to live. And when I found out about it, I was like, I'm never going to let you go homeless, dude. You can always come live with me. So he said, you know what? That sounds like a good idea. If you have me, I'll move in.
Okay, because you're helping the homeless or because you also needed help with your rent?
Yes, he wasn't okay. Homeless at the time.
All right, right? So you move in together, and what is the arrangement? Who is paying what?
Rent was $1,000 a month.
Do you have that prior lease with you here today?
Yes, I do.
Let me see that. And what did you obtain from him when he moved in?
The original agreement was we each would pay $500 each.
Now, wasn't your who is the person who you brought here today?
That is my girlfriend.
Okay. Is she the same girlfriend?
Yes.
In question? Okay. So, and wasn't she living with you?
She had her own place, but she was staying with me like 4 or 5 nights a week.
Okay. So she wasn't paying rent there?
No, she didn't have a job at the time.
All right. So according to you, the agreement is we each pay $500. And did he pay any security deposit before moving in?
No, since he was a friend of mine, I didn't require him to pay any security.
All right. When the new lease came about and the landlord demanded if he's living there, I want him on the lease, did the security deposit here roll into the security deposit there?
Yes, I've lived in the building for 10 years, so my original security deposit was just rolled over.
All right. Now, according to you, you paid a security deposit?
I thought I did, but he...
But you have no proof of it.
I have
and
no
he
proof
says
of
you
anything.
Didn't, and now
yeah.
That's sounding familiar,
yeah.
Like maybe you didn't. Because a big part of your defense is, oh, but he's got my security.
Yeah.
How do you not remember from this year whether you paid a security? Most people would probably remember if they paid security.
It wasn't a big concern for me because we were friends.
Well, how about when you got sued? Did it become a big concern for you then?
Yeah.
So is it a good idea, bad idea for two people who are employees at a place to move in as roommates?
I feel like that's a tough one. It really depends on the people, man. Like,
is it risky?
It's going to be risky, but it really just depends on the personalities.
It doesn't work out. It's going to be uncomfortable.
It's going to be awkward.
Going inside the courtroom.
So when you were asked, what's the story, your defense was, I paid a security deposit, and that should cover it, right?
Well,
that's a weird thing to say if you're not sure if you paid a security deposit.
That wasn't the only thing that...
So you end up leaving, you get a girlfriend and then you end up leaving. And you leave when?
Basically what really happened was I was not happy with the arrangement because the apartment only was a 2-bedroom and it wasn't that big. And Scott moved his girlfriend in. So I told him.
Completely?
Like I said, she was there.
No, my question is, did there come a time when you moved her in completely?
After he moved out.
Okay, go on.
We came to an agreement where instead of me paying $500, we would each pay $333 each.
Okay, is that true?
She did get a job for a little bit, so yeah, he was upset with the arrangement, so we worked it out for the time she was working. Yeah, we would each pay $333.
And how long did that go on?
3 months about. She ended up getting pregnant, and the doctor put her on bed rest so she couldn't work anymore.
So when she is on bed rest, whose bed is she resting on? Is she moved in completely
by
that point?
Yeah, once we found out she got pregnant, she more or less stayed in my house because
all
the people...
So that's March. Now, he ends up moving out when?
April. The last time I paid rent was in March. March was the last time I paid rent. It was $300. And then once she had moved in permanently, I decided I was going to go live back with my parents.
So when in April 1st, when the rent is due, does he say, hey, I need the rent? What happens there?
Yeah, I kept telling him that I was going to pay him, but then I changed my mind, which was wrong, and I never paid him. And there's
that's wrong.
Yes.
If you know right from wrong,
yeah.
That's the part that you should have thought was wrong, never paying, but go on. So you didn't pay March, April, and May.
Correct.
And you didn't try to find another roommate because, of course, you've got another roommate. And why should you? That's your feeling. Now, gas money for February, March, April, and May. On what planet would he be responsible for paying for gas that he didn't use because he wasn't there? The only gas used is by you guys. What do you mean?
Well, he was on the lease. I didn't tell him to move out. He moved out on his own.
Let's talk about what you did or didn't do. Did you make any effort to mitigate your damages by getting another roommate in there? You know that's your obligation. You're supposed to mitigate your damages by getting another roommate in there don't hemorrhage. That's the law. So you made zero effort. You sat back for 3 months.
Well, he was on the lease. I thought I couldn't get
one. Yeah, no.
Well,
what if there were 9 months left? You don't have to worry about anything. You just put your feet up and not worry about it. That's not how the law works. All right. But let's talk about the usage of the gas. That is, let me see the bills so I can see what part is February, what part is March.
You just want the gas bills, not the electric bills, too?
No, yeah, go ahead. Electric bills, too.
Thank you, sir.
What was the arrangement about how gas and electric were going to be paid?
I just gave him $100 a month cash, just like I paid my rent.
Do you have anything that can prove?
No, cash, everything.
Right. Well, I know when it's cash, so of course there's no evidence. That's when you need to have receipts,
yeah.
Because you don't have the check stubs to show me the canceled checks. Here's a proof of what I paid, Judge. Here's my check. When it's cash is specifically when you need receipts.
Yeah.
Or some, I know it's awkward to ask your roommate for a receipt, but for the love of God, just send something, send the cash by Venmo, or Zelle or something, and then you have some evidence of the transaction. That's a built-in receipt. Do you even remember when you moved out? Is it March or April?
It was definitely April.
Do you have the text that would show when you moved out?
He didn't come and get his stuff until April, but he
moved
out.
Is that accurate?
Yeah, actually, yeah.
Okay, so how do I know when the last time you paid rent is?
I paid in March. I didn't pay April. I got my stuff out of there April when he wasn't home.
Okay, is it accurate he paid in March?
No, I can show text messages.
Okay, let's see the text messages. Look at this great stuff. Chris, the rent was due 17 days ago. This is on March 27th. That's how I know you didn't pay March. What the hell, man? You have a full-time job and you work for your dad one day a week. How do you never have any money? It doesn't make any sense. You don't have a car payment. Rent is cheap. Are you giving Kristen all your money? No, I just haven't been getting the hours I need. It sucks. What are you talking about? I paid March. Right. You're guaranteed 40 hours. That's a crock of blank, Chris. You said you talked to your brother and got it fixed. Do you have the full 480? What's 480?
It was the 333 plus the 150 for bills that month.
I'm trying to come up with it. Wow, unbelievable. Just give your landlord your half. He'll have to keep my security deposit since there's only 1 month left on my lease, and I'll come up and get my stuff this week. Oh, no problem. You never gave me a security deposit. Oh, well, I don't know what I'm going to do then. Oh, I'm bad with money. I'm done making it worse for you. Out of respect, I've got to move out. I know I up, but I have no intention on... you over somehow. I will find a way to fix this. And here we are. Okay. The amount that you're suing for is the half of March and half of April and half of May?
Yes.
And why is he paying half if the rent is split the three ways?
Like I said, the original agreement was for half. She just, when she could, she helped us out. Then she was not able to work. And we were friends, so we were splitting it.
I changed my mind. I think you are entitled to sue for electric and gas that you expected to be split by half. And I am ordering him not to pay $500 a month because you're not entitled to change your rent in the middle of the agreement that has been reached. I'm going to order him to pay $999 in the rent for March, April, and May, plus half of the gas bills, plus the half of the electric bills. We will tally that up. That is my verdict. Good luck to you, folks.
Both sides, hold on.
So the plaintiff prevails in this case. Mr. Meade, the defendant's on his way out of the courtroom. You were all friends. Mm-hmm. I'm interested to know how you responded and reacted when you actually found out you were being sued.
I mean, it is what it is. I understood that he was upset about it. So it's the past. I'm not really going to let it interfere anymore in our relationship. We work together. So I think it would be best if we get along.
So you do, and you see each other every day?
Yeah.
For the most part?
Mm-hmm.
Are you still buddies? Would you put it that way? Or
I mean,
kind of cool. Huh?
We get along.
Well, that's good. That's
hopefully
important.
In the future, we'll be friends again.
Okay. Good luck to you. Thank you very much. All right, Mr. Thibodeau, obviously you're going to get the bulk of what you were seeking back. Not everything. But will you still be okay with him? You work with him?
You've
got to be around him, right? Seems like a nice guy.
He's a good kid, and you know, I tried to help him out in the beginning, and I don't like having animosity towards anybody at work or friends. So, you know, I was hoping to put this behind us and we could be friends again.
Okay, good luck. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you.
Before you move in with somebody, make sure you understand when boyfriends and girlfriends can stay without paying rent.